Do you hear that, Tim?
Yep. Could just be the house we're looking for.
Not so warm today, eh, George?
Come in, Mr. Horton.
Morning, sir.
Do sit down.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Now then, Horton, you've been with us for 20 years, and your work in the accounts department has been immaculate. No, no, please don't say anything.
Well, I have been going through a rather tough time recently. Things have been pretty awful at home. My wife, Josephine, Jojams as I call her, who's also an announcer.
Hello.
Has not been able to announce since our youngest Clifford was born, and... Well, I've just got no confidence left. I mean, I can't get up in the morning. I feel there's nothing worth living for.
Hello. I'm another announcer. My name's Dick. Joe Jums just rang me and said Jack was having a bad time with this announcement. So I've just come to give him a hand. How is it, Joe Jums?
Pretty bad, Dick.
Jack, it's Dick. Do you want me to make the announcement?
No. No, Dick, I must do it myself.
It's my last chance. Maybe I can't throw it away. I've got to do it.
For Joe Jones. For the kids.
I've got to go through with it.
Good man. Now remember your announcer's training. Deep breaths and try not to think about what you're saying.
Good evening. This is BBC One.
Good luck, Jack.
Keep going, old boy.
It's 9 o'clock, and time for the news, read by Richard Baker.
You've done it!
It's time, isn't it? Okay. Absolutely
top.
Oh, thank you.
Thank
you.
Oh,
God.
Well done.
Great.
Oh,
great.
Thank
you.
No, no, it's the best you've ever
God.
Done. It was
absolutely... Really? That was amazing. Good,
Joe.
What's the fun of
it?
What's
it for?
Get for God's sake, drink it.
Seriously, what's the voice? The voice was too good.
Bleeding happy. Oh, pantomime horse.
Then.
Caught up with the Russian pantomime horse. I think he's going to take him any moment now. But what is this? What is this? Yes, it's the pantomime Princess Margaret and the pantomime goose. And they're attacking the English pantomime horse and the Russian pantomime horse. He's got away, but who is it? My goodness me, it's the Duke of Kent to the rescue. The Duke of
to three finalists, and your judges tonight are Alec and Eric Bedser, ex-Surrey cricketers, Stuart Surridge, ex-captain of Surrey, Omar Sharif, Laurie Fishlock, ex-Surrey opening batsman, Peter May, the former Surrey and England captain, and Yehudi Menuhin, the world-famous violinist and the president of the Surrey Cricket Club. And right now, it's time to meet your host for tonight, Arthur Mee.
Good evening and welcome. Let's crack straight on with our first contestant tonight. He's last year's semi-finalist from Luton, Mr. Harry Baggett.
Harry Baggett, you're from Luton?
Yes, Arthur, yes.
Now, Harry, what made you first want to try and start summarising Proust?
Well, I first entered a seaside summarising Proust competition when I was on holiday in Bournemouth, and my doctor encouraged me with it.
And, Harry, what are your hobbies outside summarising?
Well, strangling animals, golf and masturbating.
Thank you, Harry Baggett. And Mr. Rutherford from Leicester. Are you ready, Ronald?
Yeah.
Right, it's a summarising spot. You've got 15 seconds from now. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to welcome the last of our All England finalists this evening. From Bingley, the Bolton Choral Society and their leader, Superintendent McGough. All right, Bingley, remember, you've got 15 seconds to summarise Proust in their entirety. Starting from now.
Proust in his first book wrote about
Proust in his first book.
The leader of the expedition was Colonel Sir John Teasy Weasy Butler, veteran of K2, Annapurna, and Vidal. His plan was to ignore the usual route round the South Col and to make straight for the top.
Well, we established base Salon here and climbed quite steadily up to Mario's here.
Patrice takes up the story.
Well, we knew as well as anyone that the monsoons were due. But the thing was, Ricky and I just had to blow, dry and rinse. We couldn't go out for a couple of days.
Well, things have got so bad that we've been forced to use the last of the heavy oxygen equipment just to keep the dryers going.
I know, love.
Oh, she's a treasure.
So, he decided to open a salon.
It was a tremendous success.
Challenging Everest? Why not drop in at Ricky Pugh's, only 24,000 feet from this cinema? Ricky and Maurice offer a variety of styles for the well-groomed climber. Like Hilda Tenzing and Sir Edmund Hillary, be number one on top when you're number one on top.
A magnificent aspirin!
Beatrice.
Oh, James, I could make such a fool of myself over you.
Oh, Beatrice, do.
Oh, yes, James, yes.
I can't get the fire brigade, Mervyn.
Yeah, let me try. You go and play the cello.
Oh, it doesn't do any good, dear.
Look, do you want that little hamster to live or not?
Yes, I do, Mervyn.
Well, go and play the cello. Hello?
Mummy!
Oh, Eamon! Mervyn, look, it's our Eamon. Oh, let me go. Tell me, how is it in Dublin?
Well, things is pretty bad there at the moment. But there does seem some hope of a constitutional settlement.
Last week on Party Hints, I showed you how to make a small plate of goulash go round 26 people, how to get the best out of your canapes, and how to unblock your loo.
You disgusting little piece of filth! God, I hate you! You make me want to puke my guts out!
Wasn't that cute? Remember, you two can get your own putrid Peter doll in time to pacify your next party. But why stop there? Why not get a Barry Bigot doll, too? Just watch this.
Good morning. I'm Bounder of Adventure.
Morning. My name is Smoke Too Much.
What?
My name is Smoke Too Much. Mr. Smoke Too Much.
Well, you better cut down a bit, then.
What?
You better cut down a bit, then.
Oh, I see. I cut down a bit for smoke too much.
Yes. I suppose you get people making jokes about your name all the time, eh?
No.
I have with me tonight Anne Elk, Mrs. Anne Elk.
Miss.
You have a new theory about the brontosaurus.
Well, can I just say here, Chris, for one moment, that I have a new theory about the brontosaurus.
Desdemona.
Come on!
My brain hurts! Well, let's take a look at it, Mr. Gumby! No! My brain in my head! Oh! Hmm?
The
9 o'clock news, which was to have followed, has been cancelled tonight so that we can bring you the quarterfinals of the All Essex Badminton Championship. Your commentator, as usual, is Edna O'Brien.
Hello, fans. Be garin' to be sure there's some fine badminton down here in Essex this afternoon. We really...
Gladys.
Is the man at the door with a moustache?
Tell him I already got one.